Hello and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about castor oil packs. Castor oil packs are one of the most versatile home remedies that you can have. Let's start by going over some of the ways that castor oil packs have been used throughout the years. Number one is liver health. Castor oil packs have been used for fatty liver, for elevated liver enzymes, and to help with liver detox. Number two is reproductive organ health. Castor oil packs have been used to support uterine and ovarian health, as well as reduce the size of fibroids and cysts and aid in fertility. Number three is the lymphatic system. Castor oil has been used to enhance lymphatic movement. Number four is inflammation. Castor oil has been shown to reduce inflammation in the body. And number five is the GI system. Castor oil has been used to reduce constipation, reduce nausea, and enhance digestion. And finally, number six is the immune system. Castor oil has been shown to enhance the immune system, specifically T lymphocytes, and it's also been used as an antifungal and antibacterial. In this video, I'm gonna show you step by step exactly how to make castor oil packs, including some special tips you're not going to wanna miss, like how to store it safely so it doesn't absorb toxins. Okay, so what is castor oil? Castor oil is a very thick, high molecular density oil that's been used for centuries in the home remedies that I mentioned earlier. Because of its high molecular density, it has the ability to penetrate all the way through the skin to reach the organs that you are trying to target. So first of all, let's talk about the ingredients that you're going to need to make a castor oil pack. Of course, the first one is castor oil. When you're choosing a castor oil, you want to make sure that it's hexane free. Hexane is a toxic chemical that you don't want going into your body. One other thing that I always look for is GMP. GMP stands for good manufacturing procedures. Now, supplements are not regulated by the FDA. I have a whole other video on that if you want to check that out. But GMP is kind of your next best thing because the FDA doesn't regulate it. If a product has a GMP seal, it means that it's passed certain safety standards. So this one has GMP on it and it's hexane free. The next ingredient you're going to need is an ACE bandage. Now, the reason why is most people will try to cover their castor oil pack with plastic, but when you're doing that, you risk absorbing some of those plastic toxins into your body. So I like to use an ACE bandage instead to hold the castor oil pack in place. Next up is the flannel. You want to make sure that you have enough flannel for multiple uses, and then you just cut it to the appropriate size for each use. Now, remember I mentioned properly storing your castor oil pack in the beginning of the video. I like to use a glass container, so again, I'm not absorbing toxins from plastic. So I always make sure I have a glass container on hand as well. And the final tool that you need to have on hand is tongs. Castor oil is really thick and really messy, so I like to use tongs when I'm mixing it and using it to try to keep my hands clean. So first you're gonna want to cut your flannel to the appropriate size. Think about where you're gonna wanna put it and then just cut it to that size. This is going to go over my abdomen, so this is the size that I selected for that. So now you're gonna wanna pour your castor oil into the storage container that you're going to be using for it. And this is how we're going to saturate the cloth as well. This is where your tongs come in really handy to keep your hands clean. As you can see, it's really well saturated and coated with the oil. Don't be afraid to use a lot of the oil. You can reuse this up to 20 times. Now you're gonna wanna take this to the location that you're going to actually do your castor oil pack. One of my favorite things to do is to get in bed at night with a good book, put the castor oil pack on, and leave it on there while I'm reading my book, and then go to bed. So you're gonna transport this over to wherever you need to go. Bring some towels with you that you don't mind getting oily because this oil is very thick and it's gonna get all over the place. I usually put a towel underneath me in case any of the oil slips off. I also will tuck a towel to protect my clothes wherever the castor oil pack might come into contact with it. So if I was to put this across my abdomen, I would tuck the towel into my pants, put this across my abdomen, and then you're ready for the next step. Secure it with an ACE bandage. I think this is the easiest way to do it, especially because it has the Velcro on the end. So you're just gonna take this and go all the way around wherever you're trying to secure it. That's gonna hold this firmly in place, again, without using the plastic wrap that I see in a lot of the other castor oil pack tutorials. Now, your last and most important step is going to be the heat pack. You're gonna place a heat pack over the top of your castor oil pack and your ACE bandage. That heat is going to help drive the castor oil deep into your body. You're gonna wanna leave this on for about 45 minutes to an hour. And then when you're done, you're gonna simply take everything off, put it back in your jar. Like I said, this lasts for 20 uses, store this in your refrigerator so that it doesn't go bad. Clean everything off, and you can just rub in the excess oil into your skin, and there you go. Your castor oil pack is done. I've had numerous clients try castor oil packs, and I've heard some really great success stories from it. One of my clients had less liver pain and soreness. Another one had vastly improved sleep, and yet another one had improved bowel movements and less constipation. If you've given castor oil packs a try, I'd love to hear from you in the comment box below, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you hit the subscribe and the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos when they come out on Tuesdays and Thursdays.